Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so now we learn about the markdown. Okay, so markdown ni lebih kurang pada turunkan harga. Okay, so price sometimes markdown due to many reasons. Okay, so kita turunkan harga disebabkan oleh macam-macam sebab lah. Okay, so first to face stiff competition. Okay, persaingan. So kita kiranya kita jual produk A. So, okay, so orang-orang lain pun ada jual produk A. Okay, so in order nak tarik pelanggan, so untuk menarik pelanggan, so kita kena bermain dengan harga. So, kena turunkan ke, ha, macam tu. Okay, so kena bagi lagi murah ke. Okay, so supaya harga yang kita jual lagi murah daripada orang lain. Okay, and then to encourage purchase in bulk. Okay, so purchase in bulk ni maksudnya beli secara pukal lah, secara banyak. Okay, so kita bagi mudah, bagi harga murah, so turunkan harga. Okay, so orang kan beli dengan banyak. Okay, contoh. Okay, so kalau awak beli 3 saya punya produk A, so saya akan bagi diskaun sebanyak RM10, macam tu. Okay, and then last one, to dispose of all damage or obsolete stocks. Okay, so dia nak lupuskan barang-barang lama ataupun yang rosak dan selainnya. Tapi markdown ni dia, ha, kita bukan sembarangan lah untuk markdown. Okay, ha. Okay, so berbalik pada markup yang sebelum ni. Okay, so here. Okay, so harga daripada cost kita dah markup dari atas sampai selling price. Okay, so tapi semasa kita markup tu, untuk mendapatkan net profit, kita kena naikkan harga supaya lebih daripada cost dan operasi dan operating expenses. So kalau tak lebih daripada operating expenses ni, kita tak dapat untung lah. Okay, so sama juga dengan turunkan harga. So in order to reduce to markdown, so we need to markdown. Kita kena turunkan harga supaya kita tak rugi. Okay, so kita tak boleh turun lebih daripada yang ni. So nanti kita akan ada belajar break even price tu apa semua. Okay, ha. So first kita belajar markdown dulu. Okay, so terms in markdown. So we have markdown capital MD, so decrease in the selling price, and then markdown percent. So for the markdown percent, it is always based on retail price. Okay, so this cuma ada berdasarkan pada selling price sahaja. So dia tak ada based on cost. And then maximum markdown. So MD max. Okay, so maximum markdown is one maximum value that can be reduced without losing or getting profit. In this case, net profit sama dengan kosong lah. Ha, macam tadi lah, kita turunkan sampai dekat bahagian cost operasi, operating expenses. Okay, so kalau kita turunkan sampai situ, ha, yang itu kita kira sebagai maksimum markdown. Okay, sebab kita tak dapat untung, tak dapat rugi. Okay, so break even price ni SPB, the retail price without net profit, which is NP equal to 0, and the price only cover the cost and operating expenses. Okay, so yang tu nanti saya terangkan lah. So markdown in term of diagram, so we have this one. Okay, so from the selling price, we markdown into new selling price. So here new selling price is equal to original selling price minus by markdown. Okay, so formula dia satu ni lah. Okay, senang. And then here in term of percent, so markdown we have based on selling price. Okay, so kita hanya ada dalam based on selling price. So the markdown is equal to percent of markdown times by selling price. Okay, so example here, a calculator originally sold at 65 is now sold at 55. Find the markdown and markdown rate. Okay, so asalnya jual pada harga RM65, so sekarang dijual pada harga RM55. So berapa banyak dia turunkan harga? Okay, so how much the markdown? So markdown, okay, so turunkan harga. So selling price we have 65, and then reduce the price into new selling price, which is equal to 55. So the markdown is equal to 65 minus my 55, so which is equal to RM 10 ringgit. Okay, so to calculate the markdown rate or markdown percent. Okay, so percent of markdown. Before that, okay, so we have markdown, which is equal to percent of markdown times by selling price. Okay, so because markdown is always based on selling price, so the amount of markdown this one is 10 ringgit. So percent of markdown we need to calculate selling price. So selling price kita nak pakai 55 ringgit ataupun 65. Kita pakai 65 sebab 65 ni selling price, 55 adalah new selling price. Okay, so kita pakai yang lama punya selling price, so which is 65. So percent of markdown is equal to 10 ringgit divided by 65, so which is equal to 0.154 times by 100%. So the answer is 15.4%. Okay, so next example. A book which was originally sold at 160 is now reduced by 15%. Okay, so find the new selling price. Okay, so selling price minus by markdown, we have new selling price. Okay, so in order to find the new selling price, so we need to calculate the markdown. So selling price kita dah ada 160. Okay, so diturunkan sebanyak 15%. So calculate markdown, which is equal to 0.15. Okay, it's based on selling price, so times by 160. So which is equal to RM 24 ringgit. Okay, so therefore new selling price is equal to selling price minus by markdown, so which is equal to 160 minus by 24. So the answer is RM 136. Okay. Okay, so another example. After a markdown of 50 ringgit, okay, so selepas markdown sebanyak 50 ringgit, so maksudnya 50 ringgit ni adalah markdown. Okay, so a tea set is sold for 49 ringgit and 50 sen. So this one is the new selling price, which is 49 ringgit and 50 sen. So find the markdown rate. Okay, so to find the markdown rate, okay, so we need selling price, because markdown is always based on selling price. Okay, so first find the selling price. Okay, so from the diagram we have selling price, which is selling price pula. So new selling price is equal to selling price minus by markdown. Okay, so this negative markdown bring to the left. So we have selling price is equal to new selling price plus by markdown. So which is equal to 49.5 plus by 50. So which is equal to RM 99.50. Okay, so to find the markdown rate, so we know what markdown, which is equal to percent of markdown times by selling price. So markdown amount is 50 ringgit. Percent we need to calculate. Selling price is 99.50. So we have percent of markdown. Okay, so this 99 bring to the left. So we have 50 ringgit divided by 99.5. Okay, so we have RM 0.503 RM pula. Okay, so which is equal to 0.503 and then times by 100%. So which is equal to 50.3%. Okay, another example. A pen is price RM12 ringgit and markdown by 20%. So find the markdown amount and the new selling price. Okay, so markdown amount, so we have 20%. So markdown is equal to 0.2 times by selling price, which is 12 ringgit. So we have RM240. Okay, so new selling price is equal to selling price minus by markdown, sebab kita turunkan harga. So harga yang asal kita tolakkan berapa yang kita turunkan. Okay, so 12 ringgit minus by 2 ringgit and 40 sen, so which is equal to RM 9 ringgit and 60 sen. Okay, so another example. After a markdown of 30%, a graphic calculator is sold for 875 ringgit. So what is the original selling price? Okay, so markdown is 30%. Okay, so calculate markdown is equal to 0.3 based on selling price. So times by selling price. So we have 0.3 selling SP. Okay, so 0.3 SP. Okay, so from the diagram, new selling price is equal to selling price minus by markdown. Okay, so new selling price we have because after markdown, graphic calculator is sold by 875. Okay, so selepas markdown, harga calculator itu adalah 875. So maksudnya ini adalah new selling price. So 875 is equal to selling price minus markdown, so which is 0.3 SP. Okay, so 1 SP minus 0.3 SP, so we have 0.7 SP. Okay, so terbalikkan, 0.7 SP is equal to 875. SP is equal to 8.78 pula. 875 divided by 0.7. So we have RM 1250. Okay, so next we learn about the maximum markdown and break-even price. So ni yang tadi tu lah yang saya cerita. Okay, so kita turunkan harga supaya kita tak rugi. Okay, so tu, yang tu kita ada maximum markdown lah. Tapi kalau kita apply maximum markdown ni, okay, so kalau kita buat maximum markdown ni, so kita tak untung, kita tak rugi. So kat situ dia akan terjadi break even price. Okay, so this is the concept. If the markup greater than operating expenses, so net profit obtained. But if the markup is equal to operating expenses, so break even exists lah. Dia tak ada untung, tak ada rugi. So itu yang kita panggil sebagai break even. But if markup is less than operating expenses, so kita akan dapat rugi. Ha, macam mana nak faham? So tadi daripada cost naik, kita ada operating expenses. Okay, so kita markup ni daripada sini. Daripada cost ni kita nak markup. So markup sampai ke atas. Okay, so kalau sampai ke atas ni, this one markup greater than operating expenses. So markup lagi besar daripada kos operasi. So kita dapat profit. Okay, kalau kita markup just sampai dekat atas ni je. So ni markup. So markup is equal to operating expenses. Dia sama dengan kos operasi. So kita tak dapat untung, tak dapat rugi. Sebab kita ada kos barang dan kos operasi. So tak adalah untung. And then if markup less than, kalau kita buat markup sampai sini je, sampai kat sini je markup, so kita dah tak dapat untung lah. Kita akan dapat rugi. So sampai sini je markup. Sedangkan kos operasi lagi besar, lagi tinggi daripada markup. So kita tak dapat untung dan kita hanya dapat rugi. Okay, so ni untuk konsep je lah, untuk pemahaman. Okay, so if the selling price only cover the cost price and operating expenses, then it does not make any profit or any loss. So this selling price is called the break-even price. So which is SPB ni lah. So break-even price. So we have cost here and operating expenses sampai ke atas ni. Okay, so sampai sini ni operating cost operasi. Tapi kalau kita jual cuma kat sini, so here this one we call it as break-even price. So cuma dia cuma cover cost dengan operating expenses. Okay. So therefore to find the break-even price, so we just add the operating expenses and cost. So ni gambaran penuh ni. Okay, so first kita markup dulu. Okay, so yang mula-mula kita belajar markup. So from the cost, we markup until selling price. If the markup greater than operating expenses, so ni yang merah ni adalah cost operasi dia sampai sini. So kalau kita markup sampai ke atas ni lebih, so kita akan dapat net profit. And then after markup, we have the selling price berapa banyak. Okay, so tapi tiba-tiba pelanggan tak ramai. So pelanggan tak ramai, so mungkin harga mahal. So kita kena markdown lah. Okay, so in order to markdown, kita turunkan harga, turun-turun. Okay, so turun-turun-turun-turun. Okay, so last sekali maximum markdown that we can reduce our price is until this line, sampai dekat merah ni. Okay, so daripada selling price sampai here. Okay, so this one we call it as maximum markdown. Okay, so markdown paling tinggi kita boleh buat daripada selling price sampai garisan merah ni, tak boleh lebih. So kalau lebih kita akan rugi. Okay, so kalau tak sampai dekat merah ni lagi bagus lah, sebab kita dapat untung. Okay, so if from this diagram, so we can calculate maximum markdown, which is selling price minus by break-even price. Or another one, maximum markdown is equal to, okay, so kalau kita korang nampak, maximum markdown ni adalah bersamaan dengan net profit. Sama kan, bahagian dia. Okay, so maximum markdown is equal to net profit. Okay. Okay, so dekat garisan merah ni pula, we call it as break-even price. Okay, so SPB, which is we calculate by using cost plus operating expenses. Okay, ataupun kita boleh buat selling price minus by net profit. Okay, selling price tolakkan dengan net profit. So selling price kita buang yang hijau, so dapatlah break even price. Okay, ataupun selling price minus by maximum markdown. Okay. Okay, so and then markdown max in term of percent. Okay, so markdown max is equal to percent of markdown max based on selling price. Okay, so sama je macam yang tadi, cuma bila pergi ke maximum markdown, so percent ni akan jadi percent of maximum markdown. Okay, so here example. Okay, so tolonglah fahamkan gambaran macam ni supaya senang sikit korang nak ingat formula. Okay, okay, so saya terus terang, saya tak ingat pun formula-formula ni. Saya cuma ingat gambar aja. So bila ingat gambar aja, senang. Mana nak tolak mana, mana nak tambah mana. Okay, tapi itulah, berbeza orang, berbeza dia punya ability. Ada orang dia boleh hafal formula, dia tak boleh tengok gambar aja. Okay, so terpulang. Okay. Okay, so example here. A check cost 130. Okay, so cost untuk satu kerusi adalah 130. So the operating expenses amount to 20% of the selling price. So the net profit desire is 15% of the selling price. So determine the selling price. Okay, so first kita keluarkan dulu info-info yang diberi, the given info. So we have cost, which is 130, and then operating expenses, which is equal to 20% of the selling price, so 0.2 times by selling price. And then the net profit is 15% of the selling price. Okay, so we have net profit 15%. So 0.15 selling price. Okay, so if find the selling price. Okay, so if from the diagram selling price ke atas, cost dekat bawah. Okay, so from the cost we have operating expenses. And then we have net profit. Okay, so therefore to find the selling price, we add cost, operating expenses, and net profit. So selling price is equal to cost plus operating expenses plus net profit. So which is 130, operating expenses 0.2 SP plus net profit 0.15 SP. Okay, and then collect SP. Okay, so this one tambahkanlah dulu, okay. So SP is equal to 130, 0.2 SP plus 0.15 SP. So it is equal to 0.35 SP. Then collect SP. So with SP minus 0.35 SP is equal to 130. Okay, so after that, calculate. So 1 SP minus 0.35 SP. So we have 0.65 SP, which is equal to 130. Okay, so calculate SP. So SP is equal to 130 divided by 0.65. So which is equal to RM 200. Then B, find the markup amount. Okay, so markup is the difference between selling price and cost. Okay, so boleh juga buat operating expenses by net profit. Tapi orang kena kira dululah. So this one in term of SP, here also in term of SP. Okay, so the simple formula is by using the difference between selling price and the cost. Okay, so markup is equal to selling price minus by cost. So 200 minus by 130, so which is equal to RM 70. And then C, find the break even price of the chair. Okay, so kat mana break even price? So break even price tu adalah harga di mana kita tak untung ataupun kita tak rugi. So tulis balik, lukis diagram. So dekat atas kita ada selling price, bawah kita ada cost. Okay, so sampai sini kita ada cost operasi. Atas ni kita ada net profit. Okay. Okay, so in order tak rugi dan tak untung, so kita kena jual dekat sini, betul? Sini ni. Kalau jual dekat bawah ni, kita rugi. Kalau jual dengan harga atas ni, nah kita untung. Tapi dia nak break even price lah. So break even price kat sini. So only cover cost and operating expenses. So see, break even price is equal to cost plus operating expenses. So which is equal to 130 plus operating expenses 0.2 SP. Okay, so calculate first. 130 plus 0.2 SP, which is 200, okay. So jangan korang pergi tambahkan 130 tambah 0.2, okay. So tak boleh, salah. So kena darabkan dengan SP dulu, baru tambah 130. Sebab sini darab, kita kena buat darab dulu. So it is equal to 130 plus 40. So it is equal to RM 170 ringgit. So ni break even price lah. So kita kena jual dekat 170 lah, supaya kita tak rugi atau tak untung. Okay, so next, a wedding gown cost 1,800. So the operating expenses is 35% based on cost, and net profit is 15% based on cost. Okay, so keluarkan dulu info yang diberi. Cost is 1,800. Operating expenses 35%, so 0.35 based on cost multiply with cost. Since we have the cost, so 0.35 times by 1800, so which is equal to 630. Okay, so kalau C ada, kira lah terus. Kalau tak ada, biar je dalam C. And then net profit is equal to 15%, so 0.15 based on cost. Okay, so again based on cost. And here we have the value of cost, so times by 1800, so which is equal to 270. Okay, so A, find the selling price of the gown. Okay, so selling price macam tadi, buat gambar aja dia. So bawah kita ada cost, lepas tu operating expenses, and then net profit, and then selling price. So selling price is cost plus operating expenses plus by net profit. So which is equal to 1800 plus operating expenses 630 plus net profit which is 270. So it is equal to RM 2700. And then B, so find the break even price. So break even price, okay. So dia only cover position dia dekat sini, okay. So only cover cost and operating expenses. So therefore break even price is equal to cost plus operating expenses. So which is equal to 1800 plus 630. So which is equal to RM 2430. And let's see the maximum percent of markdown that can be offered without getting a loss. Okay, so berapa maximum markdown dia, percent dia, okay. So first we need to find the maximum markdown. Okay, so kita ada cost naik sampai selling price, dan dekat sini kita ada SPB. So kita kena turunkan harga tidak melebihi daripada SPB ni, okay. So MD max is equal to, kalau kita tengok dia sama dengan net profit lah. Since we already have the net profit, so tak payahlah nak kira. Okay, so it is equal to net profit, so which is 270. Okay, so ada yang tak faham juga. Okay, so kalau tak boleh nak faham dengan net profit, so kita boleh kira selling price minus by break even price. So which is 2700 minus by 2430. So the answer is RM 270. Okay. And then convert into percent, because soalan nak the maximum percent of markdown. Okay, so MD max is equal to percent of MD max times by selling price. So MD max is 270. So percent MD max, selling price is 2700. Okay, so in order to find the percent, bring this 2700 to the left. So we have percent of MD max which is equal to 270 divided by 2700. So which is 0.1, then times by 100%. So the answer is 10%. Okay. Okay, so another question. Okay, so furniture shop bought a living room set at 1800. So the operating expenses of selling the set are 25% of the cost. Okay, so keluarkan dulu apa yang diberi. So book a living set room set at 1800. So dia beli. So masuk cost dia lah. So cost is 1800. The operating expenses is equal to 20% of the cost. So 0.25 times with cost. Tapi cost kita ada, so calculate. So which is equal to RM450. And then if the seller wants a net profit of 10% of the selling price, so net profit is 10%, 0.1 of the selling price, so times with selling price. So we don't know selling price. Okay, so tinggal dalam SP. Okay, so calculate the selling price. Okay, so A for the selling price. Okay, so we have cost here, and then operating expenses, and here net profit, and dekat atas ni kita ada selling price. So selling price is cost plus operating expenses plus net profit. So it is equal to 1800 plus operating expenses 450. Net profit is 0.1 SP. And then collect SP. So we have SP minus 0.1 SP is equal to 1800 plus 450. So which is 2250. So 1 SP minus 0.1, 1 SP, 0.9 SP. So SP is equal to 2250 divided by 0.9. Okay, so we have the selling price, which is equal to RM 2500. And then B, gross profit. Apa tu gross profit? Tak ingat. So gross profit is markup, okay? So markup. Okay, so markup, this one the difference between selling price and cost. So selling price minus by cost. Okay, so selling price 2500 minus cost. So cost is 1800. So the answer is RM 700. Okay, so another way to find the markup. Okay, so cari lagi satu nak cari markup. So markup is operating expenses plus net profit. So operating expenses 150, net profit is 0.1 SP. So SP is 2500. So which is equal to 450 plus by 250. So which is RM 7000. Sama je, okay? So mana-mana lah kita boleh pakai. And then break even price. So break even price is the price that only cover cost and operating expenses. Okay, so which is equal to 1800 plus 450. So the answer is RM 250. And then the maximum percent of markdown. So to find the maximum percent of markdown, so first we need to find MD max. Okay, so MD max we can calculate by using selling price minus by break even price. Okay, so selling price is 2500, break even price is 2250. So which is equal to RM 250. Or you can use MD max is equal to net profit, which is 0.1 SP. So same RM 250, right? Bolehlah guna dua-dua, yang mana yang selesa, okay? And then we find the percent of MD max. So MD max is equal to percent of MD max times by selling price. So MD max is 250. Okay, so the percent of MD max we need to calculate. Selling price is 2500. Okay, so calculate. So 250 divided by 2500 is equal to percent of MD max. Dan saya terbalikkan. So percent of MD max is equal to 0.1 times by 100%. Okay, so which is equal to 10%. Okay, ada lagi. Oh, ada lagi dua. Okay, so ada lagi. Okay, so SS Corporation bought a freezer for 2500. So the company want to sell the freezer by making a gross profit of 40% based on cost. So operating expenses were 10% of the cost. Okay, so first take out the info for bought a freezer for 2500. So dia beli peti ais ataupun freezer dengan harga 2500. So bermaksud cost is 2500, and then gross profit. Okay, so gross profit this one is markup. Okay, so markup is equal to 40% based on cost. So 0.4 based on cost 2500. Okay, so which is equal to 1000. Okay, then 1000, and then operating expenses 10% of the cost, so 0.1 of the cost. So we have the cost, so times by 2500, which is RM 250. Okay, so question, find the selling price. Okay, so selling price. Okay, so tengok. Kita ada cost, selling price. So sini kita ada operating expenses, and here we have net profit. Okay, so to find the selling price, cost plus operating expenses plus net profit. Okay, so cost we have, operating expenses we have, but net profit we don't have. So tak ada net profit. So tak boleh guna formula yang ni. Another one, so we know that the difference here is markup. Okay, so daripada cost sampai selling price, perbezaannya adalah markup. So since we have the markup, so therefore we can calculate the selling price by using cost plus markup. So 2500 plus by 1000, so which is equal to RM 3500. And then B, the break even price. Okay, so the break-even price is the selling price, which is only cover the cost and operating expenses. Di dekat sini, okay? Dia hanya cover pada cost dan operating expenses. So break-even price is equal to cost plus operating expenses. So which is equal to 1000 pula. Cost which is 2500 plus operating expenses, which is 200-ish plus 250. Okay, so which is equal to RM 2750. Okay, and then C, find the maximum percent of markdown. Okay, so here cost, operating expenses, selling price ke atas, here we have net profit. And here is the border for the break even price. So in order to mark down, so we need to mark down until here. Okay, so we cannot pass this line. Yes, so tak boleh melebihi garisan ni. Okay, so this one we call it as maximum markdown. So therefore, in order to find the maximum markdown, it is equal to selling price minus by break even price. Okay, selling price is 3,500. Break even price is 2,750. So which is equal to RM 750. And then convert into percent. Yes, so MD max is equal to percent of MD max times by selling price. So 750 is equal to percent of MD max times by selling price, which is 3,500. Okay, so 750 divided by 3,500 is equal to percent of MD max. So we have percent of MD max is equal to 0.214 by 100%. So we have 21.4%. Okay. Okay, so a stationery shop, another example. A stationery shop bought 400 pens at RM 20 ringgit each. Okay, so 400 pen setiap satu 200. Okay, cost is 20 per pen. Okay, so setiap pen. So the selling price for 280 pens is 25 each. Okay, so untuk 280, 25 ringgit each. And then the remaining was sold at 15 each. Okay, so selebihnya. So baki dia, ni ada 400, 280 jual RM25. So baki dia 120. Okay, so 400 minus 280, okay, 120. Okay, so the price is 15 each. Okay, so if the operating expenses are 15% based on cost, and how much net profit or loss was made, okay? So here, so sebab dia bagi setiap satu-satu dan ada harga yang berbeza, so we need to find the total cost lah untuk total semua sekali. So total cost is equal to RM20 times by 400, which is 8,000. And then selling price is equal to RM25 times by 280 plus by RM15 times by 120. So which is 17,000. This one 1,800. So which is equal to 8,800. Okay, and then the operating expenses are 15% based on cost. So first calculate the operating expenses. Okay, so operating expenses is equal to 15%, so 0.15 times by cost. So cost which is 8,000. So it is equal to 1,200. Okay. Okay, so next, in order to check whether it is profitable or loss, okay, sama ada dia untung atau rugi, So we need to calculate the break-even price, SPB. So SPB is cost plus operating expenses. So cost dia adalah 8,000, operating expenses 1,200. So it is equal to RM 9,200. So here cost and here is SPB. Okay, so cost 8,000. SPB is 9,200. But the selling price is 8,800. Tapi harga jualan dia dekat bawah SPB 8,800. So ini bermaksud apa? Nah, bermaksud di sini dia rugi. So therefore, it is loss. Berapa? Berapa dia loss? Okay, so berapa dia rugi? Equal to, so kira kerugian dia 9,200 minus by 8,800. So dia rugi sebanyak RM 400. Okay. Okay, so nak tengok dia untung ataupun rugi, kita check dia jual bawah daripada selling break even price ataupun atas daripada break even price. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. See you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.